Hey guys, it's Paul here and I'm back to make some more videos for you guys. So I know it's been a long time, you know, I want to update you guys what I've been up to and start making more content for YouTube. You know, it's been a long time, I kind of miss it. So there's been a lot of comments and I've got a lot of messages. Hey, how come you haven't been making pharmacy videos? I miss your pharmacy videos. So I'm gonna be back in action now. In the past 3 years, I started a new job as a night pharmacist at a hospital. And so I work in the inpatient pharmacy and I wanna talk about what it's like to be a night pharmacist. So a lot of you might be wondering, why the heck did you get a job as a night pharmacist? That's the worst shift possible. Which is it is true, you know, it's a very difficult shift to work, the graveyard shift, because a lot of people, you know, that changes their lives. The schedule is different, you're basically living opposite schedule of everyone else. And so it can be quite hard on the family, quite hard on your relationships, friends, and overall, it is a huge life changer. Let's first talk about what I do as a night pharmacist in the inpatient setting in a hospital. So the hospital I work at is about a 300 bed hospital. It's not small exactly, but it's not as big either. So there's one pharmacist at night and one technician. And recently it looks like we're gonna finally grow to a 2-technician night shift. So it'll be a little bit easier with the workload. Because as of right now, with one tech at a 300 bed hospital and an average census of around 250, it can be kind of difficult at times. If the technician can't keep up, that means that, you know, as a pharmacist, you might have to help out doing tech work as well, because, you know, you're running the show, you're the only ones in the hospital, and you gotta keep the patients alive and well. Depending on the size of the hospital you work at, night pharmacists work alone. Either by themselves or with one technician, 2 technicians, 3 technicians. And if your hospital is big enough, maybe average census of 300, 350, probably around 350, you'll get 2 pharmacists and several technicians, anywhere from 3 to 4 technicians. So in my situation where I'm the only pharmacist in the hospital, I check all the orders that are coming through Epic. Some of you might not know what Epic is, but it's basically the hospital software where doctors and nurses, pharmacists, all the healthcare workers use to take care of patients. You know, there's the patient charts in there, it's how you order medications, everything is in Epic. So I check all the orders coming through in Epic. And then I also do all the consults that are ordered. So the consults can be anything from heparin to vanco to gentamicin, hyperemesis, pain consults. You know, there's all sorts of different consults that are considered clinical work. And so you basically, you know, if a doctor orders vanco consult for pharmacy, that basically means the pharmacist is allowed to dose the vanco and order the vanco, monitor the labs, order labs specifically for this consult. And there's a protocol written for every hospital that allows pharmacists to do this, because pharmacists aren't allowed to prescribe, but under this protocol, the pharmacist is allowed to prescribe in this situation. One of the interesting things of working night shift is that you are the only one available. There's no management team. There's very few people around you, but depending on the size of hospital, you might have another pharmacist working alongside of you. But in my situation, you know, I'm the only one, and oftentimes I have to figure out, okay, how do I problem solve this situation? It might not be a, you know, pharmacist clinical, you know, question or something. It might be just something operational that has occurred that you have to figure out, okay, how do I fix this, or how do I make it work until day shift comes and then the management team can figure out what to do next. And so that's the nice thing, you know, it keeps you thinking and problem solving in that sense. One of the things people will often say is, oh, you're working night shift because it's slow, it's easy. You know, that's not necessarily the case. You know, it depends on where you work and the patient population you serve and how big the hospital is and how well you're staffed. Hospitals at night can be very erratic. You just don't know what you're gonna get. Some nights can be slow. Some nights will be so chaotic you don't even have time to go to the bathroom or eat. You know, it just depends. Working as a night pharmacist when it's slow, some people might find that extremely boring. They want to find something to stimulate their mind. But for me, I don't really mind when it's slow because this is the time where I can read up on things that I want to catch up on. I'm always wanting to improve and always wanting to learn new things, be it pharmacy related or other things that aren't pharmacy related. I just love learning and reading. So that's one of the things that I do on the downtime. So at night, you generally have a lot of people coming through the ER and a lot of new patients admitting to the hospital and they're getting beds. And so generally here, you'll just see a lot of home medications being restarted and just whatever else antibiotics that they need or the reason they came into the hospital for, they'll be prescribed. And in this case, you just try to get by overnight and get everything stabilized for the patient so that the day team can really look into deeply how to take care of the patient and how to get them well so that they can be discharged from the hospital. There are times as a night pharmacist where you really get overwhelmed with how much work there is, especially during the winter time and flu season. It can get pretty hectic and chaotic in the pharmacy, especially when there's only a few people working. And there's a ton of people flooding the ER and you get overwhelmed with phone calls and orders. This is the time where you learn how to multitask and figure out, okay, this order is, you know, you look at through the orders real quick if you're behind and figure out, okay, this patient's really sick. I'm gonna verify their orders first and get their meds to them as soon as possible. You know, these patients that have the general orders, that general admission orders, such as stool softeners, Tylenol, you know, those can wait. Those are not emergent orders. So in the situation where you're by yourself, there can be code blues, which means that a person is in cardiac arrest, they're dead basically, and we're trying to resuscitate them. And so in these situations, you're the only person, you know, the only pharmacist in the hospital. You have to attend these code blues, you know, try to assist in helping resuscitate the patient. Oftentimes the pharmacist is there as a double check to make sure that the doctor that's running the code is ordering the correct medications, the correct time intervals, the correct doses. And you also draw the medications up, you hand it over to the nurse that's administering the drugs, or you know, some of the pharmacists will actually administer the drugs at bedside during the codes as well. And so that is another thing that a night pharmacist does. There are a lot of other factors that you have to take into consideration if you work as a night pharmacist, including your sleep schedule, your work schedule, your relationships, your family, and your friends, and how that will affect all these aspects of your life, as well as your overall health. And I'll talk about all those things in future videos. All right guys, I appreciate your time. You know, thanks for watching. Smash that like button, subscribe button, follow me on Instagram, and also check out my new channel and Paul Tran DIY, where I build all these random things. That's my creative outlet. And so I appreciate if you subscribe to that and check that channel out as well.